penny men had tried to take him, and the penny men were dead.
I've been needing to do this video for over a year now, and it's finally time. Thanks to one of my biggest fans, ADF2309, this video can finally happen. Pay close attention to that serial number, this is one of the first early Spitfires in the game. Man, I have never got to hold one of these things, but they look cool. I can't believe I'm actually holding a Spitfire in my hands. This is incredible. This gun makes me want to play around with it. Now, there is a thing it does called inverse damage, meaning the further away you are, the more damage you deal. The hard part is actually landing shots, due to the recoil from burst firing. I love the open sight to scope feature. I wish the sharps had this. The damage is good. Hate the reload though, that drives me nuts. Wish I could have one of these for myself. Anyway, this gun is still kind of OP in the right conditions. I could only imagine using the .45-70 government shotgun rounds. It would be like an AA-12. I didn't think I would like this gun. Surprisingly, I think it might be my new favorite gun. It's a shame they removed these from auction. This one ADF has is one of the rarer ones. That aside, the damage is good. Range is good. I like the inverse damage feature, meaning farther away equals even more damage. This thing is lethal if even two body shots land. The ability to swap between sights make it versatile, and the special rounds would make it an extremely lethal shotgun, albeit expensive. Overall, the Spitfire is a good gun. I can now see the hype. Nonetheless, let's return it to its rightful owner. Thanks again, ADF, for the opportunity. This video could have never happened without you. And thank you all to my viewers. This channel wouldn't be here without you, and without Hank Sandy showing me how much of an impact my old channel made on all of your lives. So thank you all, and I will see you in the next one.